Hello, everybody. It is my pleasure to be in the annual meeting of Ophthalmic Photographers Society. First of all, I would like to thank the scientific committee to give me a unique opportunity to participate in this important event. I will talk about the optical coherence tomography profile of diabetic maculopathy. As we know, diabetes mellitus is a group of metabolic disorders in which there are a high blood sugar level over a prolonged period due to either a failure of the pancreas to produce insulin or due to the body not responding properly to insulin produced. So there are two main types of diabetes mellitus. Type 1 is called insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus, and in which there is the insufficient function of the pancreas, which failure to produce enough insulin. And the common treatment for this type is insulin injection. And type 2 is non-insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus, in which the body cells fail to respond properly to insulin. So the most common type of treatment is tablets to control the sugar in the blood. The diabetic retinopathy is the major cause of blindness in elderly subjects and develop frequently a long standing of diabetes mellitus, especially of duration more than 10 years. And the common changes associated with diabetic retinopathy actually is diabetic maculopathy, and it is a pathological disorder of the macula which frequently develops in diabetic patients and most common characterized by edema, exudates, microaneurysms, and ischemia in the macular area. So as a result, monitoring of the macula in diabetic patients is of great importance. With the development of modern imaging technologies, in vivo assessment of the retina have become possible, so spectral domain optical coherence tomography with cross-sectional image of retinal structure facilitates the study of posterior vitreoretinal anatomy in eyes with diabetic retinopathy and allows detection of subtle macular changes that are undetectable with fundoscopy. So the study aimed to investigate the macula in diabetic mellitus patients using OCT. Our objectives were to assess visual acuity and macular integrity in patients with diabetic mellitus, to determine the common macular abnormalities in diabetic patients, and to compare the macular pathologies in patients with type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus, also to provide the clinician with basis for defining the clinical features of diabetic maculopathy. Our study protocol was approved by the Ethical Committee of Scientific Research Deanship at Annenberg University. Considering subjects and methods, a prospective cross-sectional study was conducted at Mecca Eye Complex in 120 patients with diabetes. Both types were considered, either type 1 and or type 2. Patients should have diabetes mellitus for more than 5 years, and their age range between 40 to 80 years, and both gender were considered. Also, they should have normal IOB of not more than 21 millimeter mercury. As we know, the IOB has adverse reaction on the retinal layers, especially the thickness of the macula. So patients with history of ocular surgery or trauma were excluded, and also those with history of other systemic disease like hypertension were excluded, or also patients with neurological diseases were excluded also, because neurological diseases usually reflect retinal changes. So the clinical examinations were included demographic data such as age and gender and ocular history beside the onset of diabetes, and preliminary examinations to select cases such as refraction measurement, assessment of visual acuity, and fundoscopy. And optical coherence tomography were used to assess the macular profile, foveal thickness, macular thickness, and macular volume. The main study procedure was optical coherence tomography. This is an instrument which is used. It is called the OCT Meditech software version 7 2013 from German. spectral domain optical coherence tomography was used to assess the macular integrity. However, macular pubic scan protocol was used to evaluate the macula along 6 mm zone. Horizontal and vertical scans were performed also. Vision in type 1 diabetes without optical correction were 0.3, which improved to 0.5 after optical correction, with significant p-value between them. Also, in type 2, vision increased from 0.3 to 0.4, but as we see here, the improvement in type 2 is better than type 1, and as we know, the type 1 diabetes is insulin dependent, so the control of diabetes is absent as a result of failure of the pancreas to produce insulin enzyme. The study age group were between 40 to 80 years old, with mean of 55 years, and the onset of diabetes ranged between 5 to 30 years, with mean of 13 years. The distribution of diabetic retinopathy, as we see here, most of eyes has no DR changes, and approximately 15% of eyes or 39% of eyes with type 1 diabetes has DR changes, and only 10% of eyes with type 2 diabetes had DR changes. Also, the distribution of diabetic retinopathy changes reflected that the most common posterior segment lesion is posterior vitreous detachment. And as we know, in our study group, most of patients are elderly, and the posterior vitreous detachment is physiological age-related degeneration. Also, the common clinical features of diabetic retinopathy changes in eyes with diabetic mellitus, either type 2 or type 1, is heart exudates. Then we of about 27%, and about 7% has micro aneurysms, and only 3.7 had retinal hemorrhage. The assessment of the macular parameters like the fovea thickness, macular thickness, and the macular volume. So both types of diabetes cause increase in the macular thickness and fovea thickness. Also, there is increase in the macular volume as a result of macular edema. Also, the distribution of diabetic maculopathy, as we see here, more than half of study population in type 1 and type 2 has diabetic maculopathy, and that means the diabetic maculopathy may be significantly found without other DR changes. And the distribution of diabetic maculopathy changes, as we see here, the most common changes is macular edema. And focal macular edema is more than diffuse macular edema in both type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus patients. And also we found a retinal membrane of approximately 12%. And also there is some eyes with retinal detachment in both types of diabetes of not more than 45%, and lamellar macular hole showed only 2.7% in type 1 and 1.8% in type 2 diabetes mellitus. These are the results of macular regions using OCT. As we see here in the first tomogram, there is a retinal membrane with horizontal scan, in which there is a thin membrane lying on the inner part of the retina, with increasing in thickness of the retina. And the second photo here demonstrated there is diffuse macular edema with horizontal scan. And as we see here, there is optically empty area along within the retinal layer with increased thickness of the macula in all parts, either fovea, parafovea, or perifovea. And in this case, there is focal macular edema, and as we see, there is a cystic area or with optically empty structure at the center of the tomogram. And as we know, the center of the tomogram represents only 1 millimeter from the macula, which is called the foveal area. In this case, there is macular retinoschisis with vertical scan, and as we see here, there is a rupture of the retinal layers within the inner part of the retina, as we call macular retinoschisis. On the other hand, there is a shallow retinal detachment with vertical scan in this photo, and as we see here, there is separation of the retinal layer from the retinal pigmented epithelium part without any structure of the retina along the tomogram. That means there is retinal detachment. And the last photo represent that there is lamellar macular hole, and as we see here, there is total rupture of the inner and central part of the retina, which resulted in macular hole. So considering discussion, diabetes mellitus is a vascular disease that results in retinal ischemia, which lead to a pathological changes in the retina, and this will called diabetic retinopathy. So diabetic retinopathy is common in patients with insulin dependent diabetes mellitus more than non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus due to uncontrolled diabetes. However, posterior vitreous detachment is common in diabetic patient, as is it acts as physiological age related degeneration. Also, heart exudates is a common clinical features of diabetic retinopathy as compared to that found in other study in China. A lower incidence of microaneurysms and retinal hemorrhage was noticed as compared to that found in other study in South Africa. Also, heart exudates is blood components that resulted from blood leakage, either from rupture of the microaneurysms or new vascularization that lead to retinal hemorrhage. In addition, eyes with diabetic maculopathy had profound reduction in visual acuity. Therefore, it will be contributing factor for potential blindness. However, most of eyes had macular edema as a result of retinal ischemia, as suggested to other studies in Egypt and India. Furthermore, the retinal membrane is associated with increased thickness of the macula, while retinal detachment and lamellar macular hole are less common and associated with decreased thickness of the macula. On the other hand, diabetic maculopathy or diabetic mellitus usually increase foveal thickness and total macular thickness and macular volume as a result of retinal edema. The study concluded that diabetic retinopathy causes visual impairment due to maculopathy, and diabetic retinopathy is a common in type 1 diabetes mellitus more than type 2. And the heart exudate is a common clinical feature of diabetic retinopathy. However, cystoid macular edema is common clinical features of diabetic maculopathy. Also, the diabetes mellitus increase foveal thickness, total macular thickness, and macular volume. So, high definition OCT for the macula is essential to perform routinely in patients with diabetes mellitus. These are my references. Thank you.